after communion, parishioners should maintain physical distancing in the communion line as much as feasibly possible. Mass must still be worn in the communion line and must continue to be worn when saying Amen and receiving the Eucharist at the end. Communicants are asked to not put their mask down and place the Eucharist in their mouth until they step away from the priest or extraordinary minister of Holy Communion. The parking lots of St. Bridget's Church and Cemetery, St. Mary's Church and School, and Calvary Cemetery will have work done beginning early in the morning on Tuesday, July 28th, and no one will be able to drive on or walk on them until late afternoon on Wednesday, July 29th. As a result, appointments to visit the PAC will be extremely limited next week. Unless it is an urgent matter that must be addressed this week, we encourage you to consider making your appointment to visit the PAC the following week. Thank you for your patience and understanding. At the end of Mass, we ask that you please leave your kneelers down so that those cleaning will know where parishioners have sat. If you would like to help clean after Mass, you can find the supplies and instructions at the front entrance or Doherty Hall entrance in St. Mary's Church. Presiding over our liturgy today is Father Michael. Please stand for our opening.
Thank you. O God, protector of those who hope in you, without whom nothing has firm foundation, nothing is holy, bestow an abundance of mercy upon us, and grant that with you as our ruler and guide, you may use the good things that pass in such a way as to hold fast even now to those that last forever. We ask this for our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. A reading from the first book of Kings. The Lord appeared to Solomon in a dream at night. God said, "Ask something of me, and I'll give it to you." Solomon answered, "O Lord, my God, you have made me your servant king to succeed my father David. But I am a mere youth, not knowing at all how to act. I serve you in the midst of all the people whom you have chosen, a people so vast that it cannot be numbered or counted. Give your servant, therefore, an understanding heart, to judge your people and to distinguish right from wrong. For who is able to govern this vast people of yours?" The Lord was pleased that Solomon made this request. So God said to him, "Because you have asked for this, not for a long life for yourself, nor for riches, nor for the life of your enemies, but for understanding so that you may know what is right and do as you requested. I give you a heart so wise and understanding that there has never been anyone like you up to now. And after you, there will come no one to equal you." Word of the Lord.
Thank you.
he might be the firstborn. Among many brothers and sisters, and those he predestined, he also called, and those he called, he also justified, and those he justified, he also glorified. The word of the Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "The kingdom of heaven is like a treasure buried in a field, which a person finds and hides again, and out of joy goes and sells all that he has, and he buys that field. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a merchant searching for fine pearls. When he finds a pearl of great price, he goes and he sells all that he has, Isaac." The Gospel of the Lord. I spent the first half of my life mostly focusing and studying music and art. Became an artist and a composer, a singer, and spent most of my time dealing with music that was written, what we think of in our lives, is a long time ago, about 150 years or so in the 19th century. And I became somewhat convinced that the highest order of things that was ever achieved in our civilization was music in the 19th century. And when I listen to that now, I'm overwhelmed often by beauty of it. And I'm overwhelmed by what's communicated to me that I cannot describe to many of you in words. In fact, some of you have heard me use this expression, which to me is very ridiculous. That it's like looking at a beautiful sunset, you know. What did it look like? Well, it was blue and red. No one knows what that sunset looks like. They have to see. What did a piece of music sound like? Well, it was low and then it went high. And then other instruments went low and high. No one understands it at all when you talk like that. And yet, those things are part of our culture or world. Were very important to us. Some of you who are literature people can think about Shakespeare or Milton and how we were all forced to read it, and then when you read it as adults, you go, "Oh, I know why now." But we've lost that, mostly. We think of some, you know, Hamlet as, "Oh, that's the one, if you're interested in you know, Danish history, that's a good play to read." Well, that's the most foolish thing anyone's ever said about Hamlet. Anybody can read Hamlet and gain something from it. It's about humanity. Macbeth is nothing but an exploration of conscience, what happens when it goes wrong. When we do many of the things that people do today, what happens to us? We either go neurotic or psychotic, like Lady Macbeth. Those things are not explorations of history, they're explorations of human nature. And music is the most abstract, simply because I have no ability to describe to you in words what a piece of music means to me. what it means to you. The reason I bring this all up is because the gospel today talks about something of great value. Beautiful things are valuable. And strangely enough, they may have no use whatsoever. A useless thing may be an artifact that maybe when it was made 2,000 years ago or 5,000 years ago was nothing to the person who made it, except that they needed it, but buried in the desert. You pull it out and now it's priceless because there's only one. Value attached to something that has no use at all. Valuable things are beautiful. Beautiful things are valuable. We have to understand that most of us can still find beauty in nature, but not everyone. Even that has gone somewhat dull in our culture. So Jesus, when he uses a symbol of something of great value, that's beautiful, like a pearl. Some people, it means nothing to them. They've thrown off the whole order of beauty. Now, if it's happening out in the world, we know that it's happening in this room, too. That's kind of the challenge that we deal with the church, is that we're human, too. Just like everything else that's going on in there, we have it. We suffer in the same way. So we're losing that here. Every once in a while, when something remarkably beautiful happens with our choir or with any church choir anywhere in the world, someone comes up and says, "What'd you do that for, Father? You didn't need that." Again, a beautiful thing is never necessary, but a beautiful thing is a reminder from God that he loves you. It's a gift. And it's given to you to remind you of his order that he's placed in the world that keeps us all grounded and anchored and centered in reality and in love. Life. Isn't that a wonderful thing? How many of you in the last several days, as things have gone on, and as things have gotten crazy, and now perhaps as you see, well, this is going to be with us for some time, because even if they cured it tomorrow, I still got possible food shortages, increasing poverty levels, all of those things that can terrify you in 2 seconds, click on it on the internet, or watch it on television. How many of you have come to a conclusion that it's all no good? How many of you have fallen into despair? How many of you have forgotten the beauty? And how many of you at the end of that, here is the hope, have remembered that you still draw breath today? That you still are here? How many of you looked up at the sky and seen the wonder of creation? How many of you have listened to the music? How many of you have reinvested in your family, even though you can't be with them perhaps, and have said, "I'm here now, and thank God for it." Remembering that not one of us has ever promised tomorrow. How many of us have done that? That is the next step in all of this. Through this rain and haze and darkness is light. That light begins remembering that your life is valuable, and it's so valuable that God himself died for it. We remember that, and there's lots of hope. Shine that into this world that needs it. We have a little bit of a problem as human beings. We all can predict the future. I don't know if you've noticed. But when we do it, we almost always predict it negatively. So maybe we should stop and deal with today that you've been given. Deal with it with a thank you in your heart. Our hearts with the life that we have in our bodies, in our church. Some of you, as I say that, go right into the negative. Oh, but where is everybody? They'll be back. especially if you are making a light drawing on the back. If we do that, then we have everything to be hopeful for. Can we do it? I suddenly thought you were the school kids for a second by asking you a question like that. But I think we can. Have confidence in the God that made you out of love. Confidence in the God that died for you out of love. Have confidence in the Spirit that binds you in His love. Amen. Let us stand now and profess our faith and continue using the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, Father Almighty. From there, he will come to the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Trusting in God's loving mercy, we offer now to Him our prayers and petitions.
Our response to these petitions is, Lord, hear our prayer. For all who minister in the church, eager to share the lasting treasure, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For wise leaders and brave public servants, that God will guide them as they work for peace and justice in today's world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For military members and all those in service professions, that God will give them strength and help them be instruments of healing and compassion.
Pray
to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all parents, that God will guide them in nurturing their children and give them insight as they ponder options for the coming school year. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the treasure that is St. Mary's School, for wisdom and blessings for the upcoming school year, for the ability to serve, nurture, and educate generations to come, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Accept, O Lord, we pray, the offerings which we bring from the abundance of your gifts, that through the powerful working of your grace, these most sacred mysteries may sanctify our present way of life and lead us to eternal life in Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he is the true and eternal priest who instituted the pattern of an everlasting sacrifice and was the first to make to offer himself as the saving victim, commanding us to make this offering as his memorial. As we eat his flesh that was sacrificed for us, we are made strong. And as we drink his blood that was poured out for us, we are washed clean. So with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end. Pastors of your people, together with Francis, our Pope, Salvatore, our Bishop, Matthew, our Bishop Emeritus, and the whole order of bishops, that in a world torn by strife, your people may shine forth as a prophetic sign of unity and concord. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of Christ and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your faith, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us what our earthly pilgrimage has done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place, live with you forever. There in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and martyrs, with St. Bridget, St. Scholastica, and St. Benedict, and with all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you, through Jesus Christ, your Son.
Through him and with him and in him.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the wedding supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter my heart, but only say the word. Let us pray. We have consumed, O Lord, this divine sacrament, the perpetual memorial of the passion of your Son. Grant, we pray, that this gift which he himself gave us with love beyond all telling may profit us for salvation in Christ our Lord. Before we leave today, I remind you we will need some assistance cleaning after Mass this evening. So if anyone can stay, that would be great. Leave your kneelers down as you leave, if you're able. I think we've been doing most all of them anyway, every time, so whatever. I brought the bulletins out. I'm going to make sure that they're available to you in the last couple seconds, and maybe it would help me just kind of make sure people get bulletins. This week's bulletin is dedicated entirely to St. Mary's School. It's very powerful. Ms. Milano wrote a reflection on the cover that's very good about the gospel this week, and then our marketing campaign, you can see it kind of unveiled for how we're pursuing things at school, which are pretty good, all things being considered. However, you can imagine that whether or not we have school is going to have a very big impact on the future of St. Mary's School, which is the oldest school in the Diocese of Rochester at 170 years. We're very, very grateful for the treasure that our children are in that school and for the school itself. Very impressed by the efforts of St. Mary's School, led by Ms. Milano, during this difficult time over this last year. So keep us in prayer with that. That's a real challenge, but less of a challenge because of the great generosity that you've offered us. So thank you very much. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.